said, we just got chased out of the house.
Well, that's happened to me twice now. I left Josh a message this morning because I was in the toilet. I was like, Josh, there's a dog. So there's this pit bull that lives here, and it's a psycho. Like, I can hear it growling right now. And chased me into the bathroom, then it wouldn't let me out. So Josh had to come and rescue me. And now we both just got trapped in again. We were doing our teeth and we had to sit in there for like a few minutes extra waiting until we could get out. Finally we saw a gap, we ran, and this thing, I mean, it's 100 pounds,
yeah,
easily. Coming after us, growling, scratching, barking, woofing. Josh opening the gate, attempt number 1132. It's not that hard. Doesn't it feel good to be back?
Yeah. shit, kill him.
Come on, Maddie.
Come on. Come on.
Get back.
Fight.
Big legs. Big ball. Shoulders up. And over here.
Today at 7 p.m. Eastern, 4 p.m. Eastern.
Yeah.
Watch it for free. Just go to the MLB YouTube. I remember fucking on my dad's couch. Whoa. Now I got the belly and it's blacked out. Whoa. Family looking at me, then I'm not denying it. I'm a precious with my love cousin. I'm traveling and trying to keep it heavy when it's busting me. But I'm busting up the neck. I ain't going to move on the line. If I don't fuck with you, I just got tired. My high school teacher said I'd never be shit. To that bitch that I turned out just fine. And I don't know you for the 12th time.
Come on now. When you leave it in the past, let it heal like a cat. When enough time passes, you blast. Kinda like John with bars, like a convict. Fuck around, you could never stop it. Boy, just stop the high end. Go! All these other boys, and I'm murder with a
vision. I'm number one, number one, and you is just a subdivision. Never listen, we gon' leave you missing. That's the mission like ISIS. Ain't no time to pick up a fool who the nicest. It's logic, it's obvious. Just ask the audience. I'm gonna body this. I'm gonna push me, I'm Astros. My God.
I mean, Wes just snatched 160 kilos or more 5 times today.
Yeah.
Yeah, Jake snatched 160 kilos as well. 218 clean. The easiest 211 clean and jerk I've ever seen. Like, 3.5 weeks out of surgery. It's really solid. really solid. Like, they haven't had a full taper yet. This week was still pretty tough on them. Like, Monday was a really hard workout. So, I mean, the pressure in this gym was palpable. The tension. It was just, I almost felt like I needed to leave at points.
Yeah.
Like, just the fact that my presence might in any way affect the outcome of this negatively was enough to make me uncomfortable to even be in the same room.
Yeah.
This was happening. Like, I felt like I had to leave and just let Wes and Dave do what they need to do as a team. Yeah, you don't. Everyone in the gym is training hard, but they all know essentially that the only thing that matters this week is what Wes hits today. So when he's going up, and if he misses or something, the whole gym is like, they're aware of what's going on. Even if they're not looking, even if they're carrying training, everyone's aware of what's happening. Everyone at every point during this training session, everybody knows where Wes is. He knows where he stood in the room. He knows what's on his bar. Everyone knows. All right, so we're joined once again. Wait, is this once again? Have we ever done this with you before on camera?
I think we did it on like a, just a Instagram podcast. Live.
Woo. Yeah, something like that. With Jake Baker, the people's PR machine, as we called him on the podcast.
Yes, that's right.
So today you snatched 160 kilos again.
Yeah.
What was the logic in that? Because that's your PR, it's the best you've ever done.
Yeah.
You hit it last week, and I mean, then you hit it again this week. Is that just because it was without straps? You're looking for another PR?
Today was like, we kind of worked up to second attempts for a competition. Wes and Chevy obviously going to Worlds, and then I'm doing caffeine and kilos in a couple weeks.
Yeah.
The 160, I think I've just been chasing for so long. I hit it with straps last week, and that's just second attempt. I think we're going to maybe put 163 on the bar for the third. So just to feel it out without straps and kind of get the bar moving. I had five really good pulls, and finally made it. So,
well, I filmed them all. I'll send them over because it's like quite a motivational thing to see, like,
head
right there
really
every time.
Fucking with me each time I'm off the ground. So it's always kind of upsetting when, like, you know, in this environment, you try to be a professional and do your job the first time.
Uh-huh.
And if there's little things here and there that keep you from doing it, that's always kind of like, you're nasty. You should be able to just overcome that every time. So you don't get those opportunities very often. And I eventually came through today. But I'm happy with that, even though it took six attempts.
Exactly. I mean, when I spoke to you this morning, I said, how do you feel? I was kind of expecting that you were going to say great because it was a little bit of a taper week.
Yeah.
But as often happens with some people, when you get rid of all the volume, you end up feeling kind of
crazy.
Worse,
like, this is my first taper with Cal Strength. Uh-huh. And I was surprised with how bad Monday was.
Yeah.
I was missing 140 on snatch. And
wow.
Just felt super beat up.
Yeah.
But yeah, Dave was just like, you know, to be expected.
Yeah.
So just trust it.
Right.
You know, do what you can and keep working hard.
Yeah,
totally small.
That's how it is. So then how about the cleaner jokes? You smoked 80.
Yeah, 80 was good. I've been dealing with a little issue with my elbow, which feels great right now.
Is that why you didn't go overhead?
Yeah.
For the 87?
So 80 felt good, but just strong and just a little tight here. So David just said, do a clean 87. That's probably what I'll take for my second attempt.
Yeah, yeah.
And caffeine and kilos.
Okay, so more like a 92 third attempt at caffeine kilos. We're not going to see a pull on 200.
95. Yeah, 80, 88, or 87. 95.
And then 200 by AO finals.
AO finals,
That's got to be it.
Yeah.
Sweet. All right. Anyway, cheers, man. Appreciate it.
Thanks, guys.
All right. Well, this is our goodbye to Cal Strength. We've had such an incredible time here, me and Josh, over the last couple of weeks. I mean, we've spent probably 7 or 8 full days just in this place with these guys. We've been welcomed in with open arms. I mean, we were saying that it's hard to believe that there's a place on earth that feels so much like home that you had never been to before, you know, and it just so happens to be at one of the greatest weightlifting gyms in the world. And I wonder how many more gyms around the world we're going to visit and we feel the same way. We turn up and it feels like this is part of our home.
I will say, so far in California, this is the only one.
I mean, this is, there's something.
There's something
like
special
this,
about this
something
place.
About the walls in this place. It's just, it's everything I could have hoped it was going to be, and more. And from me and Josh and Weightlifting House, we just want to thank Cal Strength, thank Dave, thank Wes, Jake,
Scott.
Kelly, Scott, you know, all of these guys for taking us in and hanging out with us over the last couple of weeks. It's been real.